Well, we may not all run on Dunkin', but so many run on some kind of caffeine, and that could wreak havoc on the mission to get real rest.
Here to help us through is Dr. Katie McCullar, a postdoctoral fellow with Mass General Hospital. Doctor, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Hi, thank you so much for having me today.
So when it comes to interfering with sleep, is there a magic number here? How much caffeine is too much?
So this is a great question. As a sleep researcher and someone who also enjoys a cup of coffee in the morning, I definitely care about this topic. So in terms of how caffeine affects sleep, the amount you drink is important to consider, but the timing of consumption is also crucial. So no, there's no magic number, but up to around 400 milligrams is generally considered safe for most healthy adults. But in terms of timing, the closer to bedtime that you have caffeine, the more it impacts your sleep. So this might be a bit intuitive. So when should you stop drinking caffeine for the day to try to get the best overall sleep? So it's generally recommended that you refrain from consumption of caffeine for at least 8 hours before the time you typically go to sleep. And this recommendation is informed by how caffeine impacts the brain. So to give you a really quick overview, caffeine promotes wakefulness in part by interacting with this messenger in the brain called adenosine. And adenosine builds up when you're awake and plays a role in conveying the message to your brain that you're tired at the end of the day. So what caffeine does is basically interferes with this system and prevents adenosine from conveying those messages to the brain. And this makes it difficult to sleep. Therefore, some caffeine early in the day is fine, but if you have it later in the day, we start to worry about it impacting sleep. So we try to stick with about 8 hours before sleep with no caffeine.
I love the science behind it. Okay, we know that drinking coffee or even caffeinated tea right before bed isn't a good idea, as you say. But are there other drinks and even foods that have caffeine that we might not even think about?
Right. We have our common culprits. So coffee, tea, sodas, energy drinks, and even decaf coffee has a small amount of caffeine. But one place that you find caffeine that might be surprising and is not really obvious from the label is chocolate. So 1 ounce of chocolate can have anywhere from 6 to 60 milligrams of caffeine, depending on the concentration of cocoa. So dark chocolate has much more caffeine compared to milk chocolate. So again, a bit surprising, but if you have a dessert at the end of the night, that could actually be impacting your sleep as well.
A cup of coffee in the morning can almost start to be like a crutch or feel like one. If we want to cut back on caffeine in the name of sleep, what's your advice for replacing that jolt or energy boost you get from it?
Absolutely. So I have to say, because sleep week was last week, that my first recommendation is to just get enough sleep so you're not dependent on caffeine to feel alert and energetic. But of course, like you're saying, what can I do for that immediate effect, that jolt during the day? And the first recommendation would be to get some physical activity. So even just walking around for 5 minutes has been shown to increase your energy for up to 2 hours. So the second, if you can have a hot drink, so if you're craving something like that, reach for something like a caffeine-free tea. So again, these are just a few different ideas. And just to totally wrap up, I want to emphasize that sleep is important for more than just feeling alert. It helps with heart health, metabolism, mood, and so on. So whenever possible, try to get sufficient sleep to promote that overall health. And if you find you're feeling tired after sleeping for 8 hours and feel like you really depend heavily on caffeine to stay alert, or if your bed partner says you snore, stop breathing, or kick a lot during sleep, you may have a sleep disorder and should contact your doctor.
Okay, coffee's not always the answer. That's the message there.
Yes, yes. Thank you so much. And thanks for your interest in sleep.
Of course. Oh, boy, are we interested in sleep. Dr. Katie McCullar, thanks for joining us this morning. Have a restful day.
Thank you. Oh.